Wade here. I just felt an urge to follow up on the beautiful session that we had at the monastery on Sunday the 17th of September. And the first thing I wanted to say was a huge thank you to all of those people who turned up either in person or indeed in spirit all over the world. And I know that there were many people who would love to have been there but perhaps couldn't for other reasons. So just thank you for your presence in person or in spirit. It was just a really beautiful occasion, and the silence for me was just that peace that passeth all understanding. I just felt the urge to produce this little video because I was conscious that perhaps the sound in the actual nave itself probably wasn't that great for some of you. And although I know the vibration of the silence and so forth was there and everything was all perfect, it might just be helpful if I shared a little bit of insight and reinforce some of the insights and messages that came out on the day. So here goes. The first thing that I really feel called to share with you and reaffirm is this. Infinite silence is your true divine nature. Let me say that again. Infinite silence is your true divine nature. Now, as I said on Sunday, it's not a case of believing me on that. It's really about being totally present here now with no clutter, no ideas, no beliefs in the way. And when you let go of everything that you think you are, you present the opportunity for the true divine nature of you to reveal itself in you, through you, and as you. And when this happens, there will be no doubt. Absolutely no doubt. The video on my website guiding you to infinite silence is exactly the same. What will seem to you like a process guiding you into silence, but actually it's not a process. It's about shifting where the focus of your attention is, where your awareness is placed back into its source. You'll find the infinite silence guided experience in many places on my website, but perhaps the main page for you to go to, if you look at the top menu bar on gatewaylocation.org, you'll see a tab called support, and if you hover your mouse over that, the drop down menu will appear, and one of those says infinite silence. Click on that and there's a guided 30 minute experience on that page. Many other pages as well, but that's the key one. So do feel free to use that anytime. You'll also find it on my YouTube channel and many of the blogs where I refer to that same experience. So that's the first thing I wanted to say. The other was really connected with the monastery itself and St. Francis, because as we discovered, once the date had been set as the 17th, it was only after that that we realised it was actually a second feast day that's associated with St. Francis, and that felt very special. And the particular facet of that that I wanted to speak about, and this is what one of the things that I shared insight on in the nave, was this. One of the lines in St. Francis's prayer, which I'm sure many of you know, is this: and in dying we are born to eternal life. Now, this could easily be misinterpreted from the space of mind or ego, which are the same thing. But what this single sentence or single offering in that prayer points us to is this. The dying referred to is not the death of the body vehicle. No, it's the death of the identification with mind, ego, form, or anything that is less than the absolute. absolute truth of who we are. For when that dies, the realization comes experientially that you are indeed already this eternal life. You are life. Life is you. There is no difference between who you really are and life. This also came to me directly a few years ago now as this: life is death. Or you could also say death is life. And again, this is not the death of the body vehicle, it's the death of the ego. And when that falls away, yes, the body will still be here, but the realization of who you really are will be unequivocal, and there'll be an absolute knowing and trusting in that, and that is the self-realization. And that self I refer to constantly as infinite silence, for it is indeed infinite, and it is also silent. And again, it's not about believing me on this, it's about this becoming your experience. Not because I say so, but because you have already chosen that. The great gift of being in the body is to experientially realize who you are. It's as simple as that. This is not something that you have to strive for. It is something that you are actually already now. And when you can embrace that totally, utterly, and completely, then the realization comes. I'm not referring to your body here. I'm not referring to your personality. I'm referring to the absolute essence, the source of who you really are. And that is the infinite silence. It's so beautiful and so beyond words. Anything I'm offering here can only point at it. But here's the great news. Not only are you already this, your heart, your soul knows this. And when you listen to that, you will know. Now, the other thing I wanted to be also develop a little bit further for you was, I'm conscious that perhaps many people had experiences, insights, visions, or whatever that they perhaps wanted to share, or perhaps even had questions emerging from the day. And what I would like to be able to offer you all, for those who feel called to it, is on the events section of my website, again, gatewaylocation.org, across the top, events, scroll down to the Gorton Monastery event, click on that, scroll right down to the very bottom below the recommended posts, and you will see on there a comments section. And I'm opening that up for you to share your experiences, what happened for you on Sunday, whether it was just simply a beautifully peaceful experience, or whether there was some vision you were given, some words you were given, or perhaps a question that emerged. You can put them there. Type them into that comment section. Make sure you also click the little tick box that says notify me when my comment is approved, because all those comments, experiences will come to me, just to make sure there's no spam or anything like that. And once I've approved them and replied, you will be notified automatically, and it'll create an opportunity for us all to share our experiences. So please do use that facility. It's there, it'll be open as from now, as from the moment you see this video, it's open and ready to run. And if you have any questions, I would just say, make sure they are specifically for you personally. You know, the spiritual question relating to you. Because what I've found over many years now is one person's question is the same really as everybody else's, and there is great benefit from exploring questions. It's a key part of the inquiry that removes all the barriers to the realization of the self. I actually call the combination of experiencing infinite silence like we did in the meditation on Monday, combined with the spiritual inquiry, two wings, one angel. Two wings, one angel. You need both. The silence ultimately will be your greatest teacher, but the combination of that with the inquiry creates a very, very powerful effect. And of course, like in the wings of the angel, they merge into one oneness. Forward to hearing from you. I look forward to hearing about your experiences. Please do share them, and also look forward to seeing you again. I certainly plan to be at future free healing days. I'll certainly be at the one in October and hopefully November and beyond, and hopefully also there will be some longer events at the monastery. Thank you very much for coming, and thank you for listening. Namaste.